help you guys use it once again. You know, if you're going to interview somebody, no, that is perfectly fine. And once again, we've all got our smartphones. All our smartphones have vocal recorders. You know, write down yourself 5 or 6 questions. You know, then interview that person. Then the quotes they give you, you can use that in your speech. That is perfectly fine. Do not have a problem with that. Here's something to keep in mind though. As you guys are making your notes, as I say, as you were, you know, record all this stuff, there's always a question between minutia versus the big picture. Minutia is every little small minute detail. Here's what I tell my students. You only got 6 minutes. So when you ask yourself, should I include this information or not? Just ask yourself, if I don't include it in my speech, will it make a difference? If it doesn't make a difference, you can probably leave it out. Because, like I said, if it was an hour-long presentation, that's one thing. But you're only up here talking for 6 minutes, so there you go. And also, by the way, think about this too. As you put all this stuff together, you should also be making your bibliography too. All right, I'm going to use this, so I'll write down this is where I got it from. So by the time, once again, you're done with your research, guess what? Your bibliography is done as well. Once again, saving yourself time, energy, and effort. I always get this question, and so I'm going to answer this question for you right now. Abdul, do you care whether we use MLA or APA? Here's my answer. I don't care. In the legal universe, we use a whole different citation system, which is like... Our system is like transferring Greek into Mandarin Chinese, back into Latin, and then back into medieval English. So, as long as it's consistent, you got 3 to 5 sources, that is all I care about. We are good. Any questions, ladies and or gentlemen? So all this makes sense. How are we doing on battery power there? Still good?
Yeah, good.
All right, one more thing and we're done. I'll have you guys out of here by 2:30, if that's okay. I can go longer, because I don't have to be anywhere until 4 o'clock. I kind of figured. Okay, you got all this stuff. And so as you're gathering this stuff, does not hurt us, ladies and gentlemen, to know what to use, what to keep, what to throw away, and what to set aside. Spend a couple minutes. The marker that actually works. And luckily, this does not take too long at all. Basically, is how do you take all the stuff that you get in and how do you put it, you know, apply it to your speech? Here's the first thing to keep in mind. Anything you get, anything you gather, as you guys are putting together stuff for your speech, you do 3 things. You need to make your speech more clear, provide clarity, it makes it easier for the audience understand. hopefully it'll make your speech more vivid, in other words, more memorable, so the audience remembers exactly what you said. And hopefully it will add to your credibility as a speaker. Like I said, if you get to do all those things, that's great. If it just does one, then you're doing okay. Which brings us to our second point. How do I know what I'm using at Duel is good or bad? Well, once again, we ask ourselves some questions. Number one, are we using information in the context for which it's supposed to be used for? In other words, does it say what it's supposed to say, or is the research saying what somebody would like for it to say? Number two, is our source an expert? You know, do they have a certain expertise because, you know, they have a degree, certification, or, you know, once again, personal life experience? I had a student a couple years ago who did a, you know, speech on, you know, law enforcement. Her dad was a cop. It's like, you know what? Perfect person to talk to because he can give you firsthand, you know, knowledge and experience about what exactly it is that he is talking about. Number three, is our source biased? Believe it or not, bias is okay. Everybody says, no, you should be unbiased. No, you're human beings. We all have opinions. It's ridiculous not to expect a human being to not have a bias. Now, I expect you to be fair, you know, and if facts lead you somewhere else, then you go where the facts are. But it's okay for somebody to be biased as long as they are straightforward. I like to say number four is one of the most important things that you can always ask about the research that you got. Is it relevant? Because if it's not, why are we wasting our valuable, precious time? If it doesn't matter, why bother looking it up? Why bother using it? Once again, we're trying to make the most efficient use of you guys' time possible. Then there's number five. You know, is it specific? Is what we have? You know, goes directly to what we're talking about. Number six, is it sufficient? You know, do we have enough of it to make our point? And number seven, is it timely? In other words, how current is it? Now, here's another one of those general, as a general rule moment, so please write this down. As a general rule, newer information is better than older information. As a general rule, new information is better than older. But once again, it depends on why you need the stuff. So if I was doing a speech on AIDS and HIV, you know, an article from 2016 in the New England Journal